It's time for another Roadrunner moment.
Welcome back to the JV Sports Show, and as you heard, so as I said at the start of the show, James, you know, we had a chance to go out and make some friends out at Santan Charter a few months back, and I go back years with the superintendent out there, Dr. Christopher Sipple, and his son is also a graduate who's now playing college football in Florida. His name is Chris Sipple Jr. It's his first year out there at Weber International University. Chris, are you there?
You guys.
How's it going?
It's going well. How are you guys?
Good, man. When I talked to you back in, June, you were graduating, and you were on your way, going to be heading out to moving to Florida to play some football. Fast forward a few months. Give us a recap. How's it going?
Well, I mean, it's been kind of shaky just kind of with COVID, but I mean, everyone's just kind of trying to work through that and the season. But I mean, it's been a great experience. I mean, just kind of coming in and, you know, learning from the older guys, and, you know, it's just been a blast so far.
So, Chris, you guys said, now let's talk about the Roadrunners, because this is a Roadrunner moment, and then we'll get back and talk a little bit about you and how things are going again in Florida with, you know, specifically with how you're doing out there. But last night was homecoming. Tell us a little bit about some of your memories from homecoming and any info you have on last night's game.
Well, I mean, just kind of some memories for me on homecoming. Usually some of my best games I played was on homecoming, just because the environment that's around and just the people that are there, you know, you want to put on a show for the fans and stuff like that. So it was, I had a great experience. But I mean, yeah, I was able to watch the game last night. You know, I was really pleased with what I saw. You know, just from that first week and second week, they just are progressively getting better each week. And, you know, you love to see that as a fan. And so, I mean, it's awesome.
Would you say is a big difference? Like, you talk about the homecoming, you know, obviously that's a big game and you want to put on a show for the fans. But on the other side of the coin, how much fun is it to go on the road and ruin someone else's homecoming? I used to love doing that when we coached.
Yeah, we actually, I'm pretty sure we did that our sophomore year. I mean, you know, it feels good because we get the win, but, you know, we kind of feel for those other guys a little bit. Like, you know, they kind of want to put on a show for their fans, but, you know, we end up putting on a show for their fans. So, I mean, it's all good, but I enjoy going to another team and beating them on homecoming.
Chris, well, especially when they schedule you, you know, the idea is, yeah, we're going to schedule these guys because we're going to get an easy win. And then you go in there and you ruin their night. You know, I could just imagine, you know, the homecoming dance after the game and these guys that are like crying with their dates as they're dancing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yes.
Anyway.
Still sitting in the ice tub is really what happens after that, Vince.
Yeah. So Chris, tell us a little bit about Weber International. You guys are NAIA. You know, how's the season going? I mean, give us a little more, some more nuggets of what's going on out there. We don't know a whole heck of a lot about them.
Yeah. So with COVID and everything, we ended up reporting late as most people did. So we had a couple weeks to just kind of, prepare and just kind of get ready for the season. And we played three games. We were 1-2. We played two, ranked teams. So, I mean, that 1-2 record, you know, it looks like 1-2, but those two losses are against two ranked teams. So, I mean, it's been awesome. But, you know, right now, it's crazy with COVID and everything. Our last two weeks just got postponed because of COVID. You know, a couple players got COVID. So, I mean, the stuff that's going on in the NFL, I mean, it's going on in the NAIA, and I'm sure it's going on in other colleges. So, you know, everyone's just trying to adapt to that and make the best out of the situation.
Chris, what would you tell a high school player who might be listening to the program? What is the biggest difference besides the speed of the game? What is the biggest difference between going from the high school level and stepping up into that college level of football?
Well, I mean, back in high school, you're kind of the dude. Everyone knows your name. Everyone loves you. You know, the coaches love you. When you come into college, I mean, especially as a freshman, you got to work for everything that you got. You're not giving it. starting back over from ground one like you did freshman year in high school. So, I mean, honestly, for me, that's been it's been exciting to just kind of go through that process again and then work my way up the depth chart. You know, that's always fun to do.
Chris Sipple Jr., quarterback at Weber International University, an NAIA program in Florida. And James, as you know, we cut our teeth with NAIA football. That's where we started.
Sir.
That's what we continue to do. And it is great. It has created so many opportunities for student athletes. Number one, that want to stay close to home. But secondly, there's how many schools out there? Hundreds of NAIAs.
Oh, yes. So many good schools offering great education, great playing facilities, great campuses, great you know, facilitators and faculty members and everything. So, you know, it's great to go play at USC. It's great to go play for Coach Harbaugh at Michigan. I'd be on the plane tomorrow. But you know what? Football's football, if you ask me, Vince.
Oh, 100%, 100%. And then we've got our friends, NAIA F-Ball, that are out at in Florida that we collaborate with that cover NAIA as well. So
yes,
we'll have to make sure and keep tabs on Chris and Weber and how things are going out there throughout
and a great
the winter
segue,
and spring.
Vince, as well. A great segue with the NAIA football here tonight. We have some NAIA football tonight in the Valley of the Sun over at Greenway High School. Arizona Christian is hosting Wayland Baptist tonight.
Yes. Yes, so there is college football going on. Chris, I want to say this from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much for joining us. We're going to check back with you periodically to see how things are going. And keep us posted. Give us a shout-out once in a while. Let us know how you're doing, and we'll do the same. And we'll also keep tabs on your old alums there at Santan Charter. Picked up a great win last night at homecoming. Congratulations to Coach Kerry Taylor and another Roadrunner moment.
Yes, thank you, guys. I just want to give a quick shout-out, though. You know, my brother, he had his first high school touchdown last night. So just
no
shout
way.
Out to Kenneth Sipple. Yeah, he had a touchdown last night. So it was great to watch that as a brother.
Oh, that's
fantastic.
Awesome.
A proud brother moment. That's awesome. Thanks so much, Chris, for joining us this morning. We'll follow your progress out there at Weber. And who knows, maybe we'll see you guys playing the OUAZ Spirit one day.
Yeah, maybe. Thank you, guys.
All
thank
right.
you, pal. Appreciate your time.